Ladies and gents, got a little bit of Whitney Houston and Deborah Cox talking about the same script, different story. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be talking about this TDA account thing and this birth certificate bond. Look, first, it is necessary that you all stop listening to these individuals who are just doing videos and just talking. Because first, they're not backing up or verifying anything they're talking about. For instance,
then your birth certificate bond became a negotiable instrument just like a security instrument under UCC Article 3 code of the Uniform Commercial Code, commercial law, in which the World Trade falls under.
Okay, sounds like it's accurate. Sounds like the information is verified, bona fide. No, ladies and gentlemen, it sounds like nothing. He says under the UCC Article 3, where? Where, what particular article are you talking about? No, I can tell you it's a negotiable instrument. I can prove it's a negotiable instrument. But the reason why we're pulling this up, because I want to go to the Treasury direct. Treasury direct issued a quote unquote. Give me 1 second. Treasury Direct doesn't like me. Give me 1 second. I'll be right back. Okay. Apologize for that, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go to the Treasury Direct and let's see what they got to say. Maybe my reasons are wrong, but let me explain, because I know after this you'll believe.
Several internet blogs and videos make false claims that the United States birth certificate is a negotiable instrument.
Now, please understand, it says, by putting this in parentheses,
a document that promises payment.
The reason why they put that in parentheses is because they're issuing a presumption. They want you to know that those internet site is promising that the birth certificate promises you a payment
that can be used to make purchases that will be charged to an exemption account.
Now, you notice how they highlight that? Now, pay attention, perhaps
identified by Social Security number or EIN.
Or EIN, whoever said that your exempt account is associated with an EIN. Well, first of all, Social Security number and an EIN are interchangeable. We've seen that under Title 31, Code of Federal Regulations 636.6.10.20.22.27. Okay? That's where you can find out about the EIN and Social Security number being associated with each other. But nobody, I don't know anybody who has provided any proof that said that, wait a minute, Social Security, your birth certificate is associated with an exemption account. See, they don't explain what an exemption account means. They're telling you now the exemption account is perhaps identified by Social Security number or EIN. Perhaps. So what does Social Security number identify? What accounts are associated with Social Security number? You notice I asked what accounts with an S are associated with Social Security number. Now, the reason why I'm doing this is because Heather Giraffe has been found guilty on all counts. Why? Because they said she was guilty of wire fraud and some other financial transactional laws. Ladies and gentlemen, was she guilty? No. She just thought that she could go in and expose the system in front of the system. You can't do that. They won't let you. They will hold a trial. All of the members of the jury, every single one of them, being, now, you don't have to ask me, but every single member of the jury that they bring to sit on the jury, in cases like Heather, these are agents. These are individuals who actually work for the system. You know how you've got this group that will bring protesters? All you got to do is ask them to show up at your rally so that they can have like protesters and a bunch more people. You know, like the fake events. Okay, the same thing with juries. They're already prepped to answer certain questions. Okay, That's why you don't get to determine who is the jury, how the jury is selected. The only thing the law requires is that they be voters. There is nothing in the law that says that they can't stack the jury. That's why none of you have ever been on a high profile jury. Okay? Sorry. OJ? They didn't do that in OJ's day. They do that now. Okay, let's go. This is the, pay attention, this is the Treasury. The truth is, excuse me, the truth? The Treasury, the government is going to tell us the truth. So let's listen to their truth. Birth certificates cannot be used for purchases. Of course you can't use a birth certificate to purchase anything. Why would you do something stupid like that? Okay, did they say anything about them not being negotiable instruments? Remember, that's what they said, that they make false claims that United States birth certificate is a negotiable instrument. So do they speak about, I haven't read this article, I just saw a lady doing a video on it, okay, because she was talking about the exemption accounts and talked about how she was going to explain this. Ladies and gentlemen, negotiable instrument is a legal term. It's two words combined as a term, not a word. So negotiable instrument, it's legalese, not English. So they said they make false claims that birth certificate is a negotiable instrument. Okay, let's find out what a negotiable instrument is. You guys don't mind? Because I don't mind. Let's go. That's many. Rippleton. That woman had a voice, didn't she? Sit up there and break our glasses. A negotiable instrument is a document guaranteeing the payment of a specific amount of money, either on demand or at a set time, with the payor's name on a document. More specifically, it is a document contemplated by or consisting of a contract which promises to pay of money without condition, which may be paid either on demand or at a future date. Negotiable instrument, this is Wikipedia. Okay, now remember, you need to understand, they're saying payment of money. Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, what's the definition of money? That's why I don't go to Wikipedia. I want the actual negotiable instruments law. Shall we go there and find out what does Cornell law have to say about negotiable instruments and not Wikipedia? Because that definition that they just gave, I know for a fact that's not the definition. Look, except as provided in section C and D, we're going to go down to C and D, negotiable instrument means an unconditional promise or order to pay a fixed amount of money without interest or other charges described in the promise or order of it, is payable to the bearer or to the order at a time it is issued and first comes into possession of the holder, is payable on demand or at a definite time, and does not state any other undertakings or instructions by the person promising or ordering the payment to do so to act. In other words, it's unconditional. It's an unconditional promise to pay. Okay, a promise to pay is a negotiable instrument. That's why it must be accepted. So checks means a draft. Other than a documentary draft, payable on demand or drawn on a bank or a cashier's check or traveler's check. An instrument may be a check even though it is described on the face in other such terms as money order. It says it may be a check even though it is described as money order. Why did they update it, ladies and gentlemen? Interesting, ain't it? A money order is not a check. Okay, a coupon is not a check. And they know that. Okay, let's rewind our tapes so that we find out. We don't get the dates of the revisions. And so let me make sure you guys understand. Let's ask the question. I'm asking Google a question. I'm asking, is a bond a negotiable instrument? Okay, but it gives me, I don't want that. I want, are bonds negotiable instruments? Let's see. Municipal bonds as negotiable instruments. Imagine that. So a bond is a negotiable instrument. Isn't that interesting? Do you know why I did that, ladies and gentlemen? Okay, I don't care about the Freedom School. See, negotiability of corporate bonds. The reason why I ask that is because they take your deed of trust. Do they not convert that to a negotiable instrument? So that's why that is asked. Okay, let's finish. She never takes it off. So again, they don't mention anything about a negotiable instrument. That the birth certificate is not a bond. So is it a bond? Is it not a bond? It's on bond paper. Is a check a bond? It's on bond paper for a reason. But the truth is, birth certificates cannot be used for purchases, nor can they be used to request savings bonds purportedly held by the government. Savings bonds? Who said there was a savings bond held by the government? Anyway, also, the exemption account is a false term. These accounts are fictitious and do not exist in the treasury system. Ladies and gentlemen, the fact that individuals say that you have an exempt account, it's the way they're saying the term. It's not an exemption account. It's an account exempt from taxation and other so-called penalties. You want to make sure your account is exempt, you get to file for exemption. Okay? You have the right to file for exemption. Let's see. The story. The story is a variation of older bogus site drafts, bills of exchange drawn on treasury scams. Okay, so y'all need to stay away from them bogus things. I don't even think bogus is a legal term. Anyway, let's go ahead and move forward. The commentel offered in this scam states that the United States went off the gold standard in 1933, which is true. The federal government has somehow went bankrupt. Sorry, the U.S. Congress has identified the United States as going bankrupt. With the help of the Federal Reserve Bank, the government became a corporation. With the help of the Federal Reserve Bank, the government became a corporation. No, the government incorporated itself by the act of, what was the date of that? February 21st, 1861? Okay. You don't believe me, go ahead and look at the corporate papers. Go ahead and look at the act. DC is a corporation. DC code 1-101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 109. Okay, DC code, just go look it up. But according to the Treasury, none of that happened. That stuff doesn't exist. All right, let's go on. And converted the bodies.
They converted bodies.
Of its citizens into capital value. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is a lie. The government did not convert the bodies of its citizens into capital value. Okay, so y'all don't listen to stuff like that. No, the government actually took ownership of all property, and there is no more individual so-called ownership. That ownership of all the property of the United States is through government. See, only by virtue of the government. Okay, and that they mortgaged this property, because it's all referred to as government obligations. And pay attention, it represented a mortgage on all of the homes and all of the people of the nation. Because people is deemed to be property. So when it says all of the property of the people, remember, slaves were deemed to be property. Animals are deemed to be property. I didn't make it up. They made these laws. They said that. This was Congress explaining this. That's why we had everybody go and look for the original House Joint Resolution information. We pulled that stuff up. Where is it at? No, that's not it. Hold on. Exemption document, Moses Washington, PDF. Okay, this is talking about the Emergency Bankruptcy Relief Act and so on and so forth. Okay? we went ahead and pulled up the actual docs where they are actually talking, but this is an exemption doc from Mr. Washington, Mr. Moses Washington, the one who wrote the U.S. bankruptcy doc. And as I told you, we always go and we look up the information. Okay, give me a second, y'all. I'm looking for, I can get rid of this because I don't need that. I don't need Carpenter and Logan. Although that's a good case because that's where the Supreme Court highlighted a couple of things. Nah, it's not here no more. I don't know what I did with it, y'all. See, satisfaction of mortgage. Federal Emergency Relief Act of 1933, the act of May 12, 1933. I didn't say the government was bankrupt. They did. We can even go down to section number three, or section number four, excuse me, where remember, the government is there to provide for the needs of the people. If you ain't seen this yet, you need to go take a look at it, okay? But it says to meet the cost of furnishing relief and work relief and in relieving the hardship and suffering caused by unemployment in the form of money, services, and materials and or commodities to provide the necessities of life to persons in need as a result of the present emergency. Ladies and gentlemen, the government is to provide for the necessities of life of anyone needy inside the government, whether the person is a dependent, whether the person is a resident, whether the person is a transient, whether the person is homeless. Wait. Well, how you say that there's an account? Oh, because you guys haven't paid attention.
Of the amounts made available by this act to not exceed $250 million shall be granted to the several states applying therefor in the following manner. Each state shall be entitled to receive grants equal to 1/3 amount of the expended by such state.
Okay, pay attention. The state creates an account. You have an account with the federal government, which is through the UCC. Okay, then you have another account with the state. I didn't make this up. They're the ones saying this. Okay, and if you go back to the beginning of this act lets you know that the account exists. Okay, but the phrase, pay attention, because you guys are not listening. The phrase exemption account, it's referring to the fact that it's not taxable. Okay? All right. So pay attention. The Emergency Relief and Construction Act of 1932. Now the Emergency Relief Administration is now FEMA. Okay? The Federal Emergency Management Administration. This used to be the name of FEMA. So again, you have to not listen to what other people are saying because they ain't done no research. They just parroting what they heard somebody else say. So according to the Treasury, what I just told you is bogus because it's not the truth. Okay, now, and remember, the Federal Reserve gave and helped the United States become a government franchise. Government franchise? Have you heard anybody say anything about the government being a franchise, or have you heard them say the government is a corporation? Why, everybody knows the government's a corporation.
No, we don't. We don't know the government's a corporation. How you get to that point where you can say the government the corporation?
Ladies and gentlemen, this is how we can say the government's a corporation. We're only going to cover this for a minute because we're at 19 minutes. So watch this. DCCODE 1-102. Oh, and by the way, see, the districts have created a body corporate for municipal purposes. The district has created a body corporate for municipal purposes. See, constitute a body corporate for municipal purposes. They are a corporation. All government is a corporation. The law says all government must be a corporation, can only be a corporation. Because what's a corporation? A group of bodies, group of peoples coming together. Corporation. That's why there needs to be a board. Okay? A sole proprietorship is not a corporation. It's a sole proprietorship. It's only one person. Oh, God. Yes, I know you didn't get that at first, but you should get that now. Okay, and when you do the research, you'll find this comes from the Act of 1871. It's literally called the Act of 1871. Hold on. Hold on. So that you guys get it. The District of Columbia Organic Act of 1871 is an act of Congress that repealed the individual charters of the cities of Washington and Georgetown. George Washington, see, Washington and Georgetown, George Washington, and established a new territorial government for the whole District of Columbia. Now you see this? They say this established a new territorial, no, that's Wikipedia. It did not establish a new territorial blah, blah, blah. Ladies and gentlemen, the Act of 1871 did not establish a new territorial anything. It put the, well, let me make sure that you guys understand where I'm coming from, where I've come and been, and how everything is going on. Sorry, they were coming to let me know they were shutting the water off. And so I had to give them permission to do so. All right, now.
They're shutting your water off. Oh my God, you need some help?
They're doing some work, people. Now let's get back to this organic thing so we can prove to y'all that they created a government that is a corporation. We're gonna go back. And we got 102. And then we're going to go to 103. The territory area, District of Columbia, and a portion of the United States ceded by blah, 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 blah. Permanent seat of government of the United States. See, the district is the permanent seat of government for the United States. But hold on. And the district created a body corporate for municipal purposes. Okay? So the permanent seat of government is inside a corporation. It's called the Government Reorganization Act. Reorganization is Chapter 11. Don't take my word for it. Reorganization is a legal term. So let's do legal definition of reorganization. Reorganization, the act or process of changing the way something is organized. Oh, look at that. They just used an English definition. So watch this. Let's do this. Reorganization law or legal definition, reorganization in a corporate context refers to the initiation of a plan to restructure a corporation, such as restructuring may be involved in a company being merged with another. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, when governments reorganize, all government is a corporation. Let me prove this to you. Okay, and see, this talks about a government-owned corporation. We don't care. We didn't ask, all government is a corporation. We didn't ask about which corporations are owned by the government. See, it did the same thing, but took out my quotes. All right. I don't care about the United States as a corporation. Let's do this so that you guys know, because I don't care about the questions. So let's do this. Nope, don't care about that either. I don't want to keep you guys here. I forgot the name of the case, and I think it's Cohen
But hold on.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. We were looking for the municipal purposes, because that was the phrase that many of the other locations have used. Many of the other places have used, but what I could have just said is the EIN or the DUNS number for the United States, or the EIN and DUNS number for the state of California. Okay, let's do this.
Had to sneeze, y'all.
If an organization does not yet have a DUNS number, or if no one knows it, visit the Dun & Bradstreet website. Okay, but I put in what is the DUNS number for the state of California. So let's do this. We put question mark. And I want to know, y'all. Okay. Chapter 10500, Basic Institutional Information. Okay, but it's not giving me the state of California DUNS number. And it should have pulled up because many people have posted the DUNS number for the state of California. Okay. All corporations are associated with Dun & Bradstreet, especially if they do international trade. They will get themselves a DUNS number. But if you notice, it's not listing the DUNS number. Okay. This is a corporation formed in the state of California. See, nobody cares about the corporation being formed in California. We care about the DUNS number for California. I have a list, and I don't know where that list is, that has all of the DUNS number. Hold on 1 second. Wake up. A list of the Dun & Bradstreet numbers for the states of the United States. Stop listening. See, it's not giving me that, and I really do hate the fact that we have to do this way. This is the research part, people. I don't want a Dun & Bradstreet number lookup. Ladies and gentlemen, gotta give Foreigner their credit. This song right here,
Let's Talk About Love,
is my favorites.
I wanna feel you. I wanna feel you.
All right. Let's see if we get a different result. See if this is not insanity.
Let's talk about love.
Oh, there it is. All right. Just have to go to another source other than Google, because Google will mix it up within those 57 million results that pop up. Okay. So let's pull it up. This list is in a different format than the one that I had, but pay attention. These are all the DUNS numbers for these different little places. Oh, look at that, foundations. Okay, but Washington. Okay, IN, United States of America Incorporated. What you guys need to understand, DC code, let me see, DC code 22-34, dang it, I don't know the code. DC code 22-3401 through 3403, and in particular 3402, says that you cannot use the name of government in your quote-unquote title of your company, okay? So let's see this and go ahead and try to set up a company that has the same acronym and tell them you want to use the same acronym of a United States corporation such as the SEC. See, United States, file number, nonprofit religious, Delaware. Okay, this says formation date, 1989. Ladies and gentlemen, not 1989, been around for a while. And this is this one, not that one. Okay, not the actual document I'm looking for. The one I'm looking for shows all the DUNS numbers for all of the different corporations. So this is not the document, sorry.
I thought it was the way it was labeled.
Especially when it listed. I don't care about the IRS. Ladies and gentlemen, you guys also have to get off of that that roller coaster ride that all of you guys have been taking. Talking about government, being against government and all of this stuff, you cannot do that. Okay? You not only will they make you sound like you're crazy, and I'm sorry, some of you are. What? Like I can't tell the truth. Some of you are completely stoned out of your minds. And then some of you decide that you want to go on a rampage and do videos and try to explain this stuff to people when you don't know enough to be explaining it to nobody. Okay? Shame on you. Okay? All right, you know what? Let's do this. Okay, hold on. I want you guys to see this because here's a video on YouTube that explains it. Okay, why is the United States Supreme Court listed as a private corporation on Dun & Bradstreet?
All right, everyone. Jeff here at StopThePirates.blogspot.com. Just wanted to do a follow-up. You know, I get a lot of bad feedback and whatever from the video I did about, you know, same-sex marriage. But you look right here. This is Dun & Bradstreet's website. And you can look right here. I just typed in Supreme Court of the United States. There you go. It's a privately owned, run-for-profit corporation listed on Dun & Bradstreet. They got a DUNS number, and they're listed with the Department of Defense. And
of course they're listed with the Department of Defense.
That's who they are, man. They work for the creditors, creditors control.
No, now he's making statements, ladies and gentlemen. You can't do that. Those are statements. He has no proof of that. He's not providing any proof when he talks. So, Mr. Stop the Pirates, I would have given you credit until you started doing all of that. Okay? You don't make statements that you cannot back up, verify, vouch. Okay? So we're gonna do that. Let's go to Dun & Bradstreet search and look up. Beautiful, the beautiful, oh. I like this song, Most Beautiful Girl. We're going to go, because Dun & Bradstreet controls the entire world, ladies and gentlemen. It's all commerce. Very big organization. I'm being redirected. Then you need to hurry up. I didn't ask you to send me no place else. I was comfortable right where I was. TikTok, TikTok, TikTok. Okay, webpage, where's my search result? I haven't been here to Dun & Bradstreet. Continue to... Oh, to safeguard your business identity, Dun & Bradstreet government ID update for an automatic security protocol that establishes association between you and the businesses you select and confirm you are who you say you are by asking you to answer a few individual base challenge questions. Yeah, you're apologizing for any inconvenience because you didn't tell me I'd have to go through this to look up a name. So I think we're in the wrong site. Wrong site. Let's go back one page. Passenger, I thought I recognized that voice. Y'all, if y'all don't know nothing about Passenger, y'all got a problem. Passenger is all right. Okay? Passenger is all right. The only problem is all of his songs sound the same. Give me one second. I'm looking for look up. If it's the same page, then it ain't like it used to be where you can just go in and type in a number. Type in the name. So I don't want to contact y'all. Y'all don't mean nothing to me. Let's see. Okay, I put a United States of America, and we're just going to put that, and we're going to see where it's listed at, what state, and all that stuff. Going to do a general search. Oh, it wants a state. Chamber of Commerce of the United States of America, Veterans Foreign Affairs, United States Department of America, Department of Washington, Officers Christian Fellowship of the United States, National Council of Young Men, Christian Association, YMCA, United States of America, Chamber of Commerce, for the United States of America, Chamber of Commerce, Non-Commissioned Officers of the United States, blah, 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 Council for Young Men, United States of America, National Karate Do Foundation? Okay, United States of America, okay. And of course, you know, they're not giving us everything. So let's do, watch this. Oh, states of California, because I didn't type it in right and I put in states as opposed to singular. So let's get that taken care of and that taken care of, and now we gotta put in, yeah, we can still do Washington. I know it's gonna be Delaware, and I don't know why I'm searching Washington. So watch this, it's Delaware, people. That's my fault, because all of them are listed in Delaware because of the tax breaks. Look at that, they don't have the state of California. So let's do this. Play with me. Nope. And I know I have the whole list of them. Okay. So they don't have anything for California now. Before it was there. Let's see. Okay, so now it doesn't have it. All right, that kind of pisses me off. That chats my hide. What I'm going to do is I'm going to look for it, y'all, because we're looking up something else. But I'm going to look for it. Get this right here. All right, I will look for it, people. I will find it. I will find it. I will find it. So what I'll do is one more pause, 1 second. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, again, that's what makes the way I do videos different from everybody else, because I do the research while doing the video. So it's not something that I prepared so that I can point you in a particular direction. This is so I can prove to you that I know what I'm talking about. This is the document. Okay, you see the title there. Just put in that title, and this is Scanned Retina. And this is a site that I've been to before, okay? Okay, these are the numbers. Alaska, California, Washington, Wilmington, Delaware, Minnesota, Los Angeles, all of it. Okay, then you got the United Nations. Then you got the World Trade Organization, which is not listed here, but you have the WHO. World Trade Organization is just about as powerful as every one of these, with the exception of this one. Okay? But this is the list. Somebody, this is not the paper list, but this is the list of all the agencies. So somebody took the time to post the list here, okay? And even the states, that's why I put in state of California. Now look, let's do this. Let's test this out. Copy. Because remember, when I went to Dun & Bradstreet, Blad Street, it didn't pull up anything. So let's see. And this was 2015. So give me a second.
But I refuse to fall with you again.
It's my girl. Her name is Lisa.
Fisher.
And Lisa
Fisher
had a voice, y'all. All right. Anyway, let's go on with...
I'm not knocking at the door.
This is not a Dun & Bradstreet. This is another search engine. I never heard of that search engine, so I'll leave it open. No, I don't want to go to ask. I did not ask for ask. Did anybody see me ask for ask? No, we got to get rid of ask. I don't like ask, ladies and gentlemen. And I didn't ask for these intelligent people either. So because you sent me over to ask and I didn't ask for ask, bye-bye. I want dunce, D&B. I didn't ask for Dun number products. I said Dun's number. These are all ads, ladies and gentlemen. Uh-oh, sorry. Yeah, let's just go here. Still ads, and I may have to go to Google for this one. There we go, official site. That's what we're looking for. That's what I'm talking about. TikTok, 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 TikTok. Okay. Now. Oh, so now you gotta pay. I don't want to report. I just want to search. I'm making this song for all the people who at times in their lives feel bad. This is my boy. And he's, his name is Richard Dimples Field. It wants me to search a state. So I need to look, see what to do with a number. Crazy mixed up world. It's a doggy dog world. People just aren't nice, y'all. Running games on this and that. Racial resentment adds to discontentment. Talk to any guy. Taxes are too high. Books, these are corrupt. Suicide is way up. Ladies and gentlemen, I cannot find that. Wait, hold on. We got dunce numbers here. Okay. Let's see. See, I looked up for the state of California before and that did not come up. Let's see. Let's get another one that we know should not be a corporation. No. Yeah, let's do Department of... Let's do U.S. government.
man could pay. Still, he's not a holiday. Messing with my mind, leave me a Frankenstein. Oh, my son!
I think that's what I'm supposed to be looking up.
Doctors give me dope to quote. Doctors give me dope to cope.
This ain't what I'm looking for. How come I can't find what I'm looking for? Because they see all these people doing videos, and what they did is they realized they can make money because they saw the traffic coming in. Okay? My funky two-bit job went on strike. This ugly woman named Sadie called me up and said she was having my baby. Lord have mercy. Heck on earth.
It's all I am and got no life. Don't give a.
You gotta put up with a lot of bull. Come on now. It's not letting me select. Okay.
One thing, it's another.
Okay, we finally got there, y'all. It took long enough, but we finally got there. Now it's asking for business. I want not the business, I want the number. It ain't letting me look up the number, y'all. It said it was gonna take me to looking up just the number. So it ain't gonna do that, so. That's why I went back and undid what I did and selected the name. And we already put in state of California, copy. City of Los Angeles is next. Now remember, many of you are going to think state of California is registered in the state of California. It is not. It's registered in Delaware. It's a Delaware corporation. My son, my child. Don't you ever. Matthew chapter 24, y'all. Said, when are these things going to happen? Nope. See, we know the numbers exist, but now they blocked it so you can't search for it. Imagine that. Well, there you go. Tried to show it to you, but let's get back to the conversation at hand. You can go to this site, pull up all of these numbers. That's your evidence. You won't be able to use it. They will never let you, like with Ms. Tootsie. They'll never let you introduce it as evidence in a case. Sorry. It's just the way they do things.
This is how we do it.
Okay. So let's go back here and not there. Is it here? Nope, that ain't it. I'm looking for that treasury site so we can finish going over that so I can finish showing you guys about the treasury. Okay, so it ain't this one. So we can get rid of this and get rid of you. And we're going to go back. We are right where we should be, but this is not the page either that we want to be. Nope. I must have closed it out dealing with the treasury. And that's a shame. Yeah. Let's get rid of you because I think I know what I did. There we go. There it is right there. This is the treasury. Again. The story, and they try to tell this is what people believe. It says, scams vary in method for citizens to gain control of their alleged assets, such as filing UCC Financial One statement, activating a Treasury Direct account, or creating bonds using saving bond calculators. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, you don't create the bond in that way, but nonetheless, okay, these blogs and videos promise that your birth certificate bond will be able to wipe out all of your debt and help you collect monies and securities. Really? So you guys need to stay away from that. See, the reality is there is no monetary value to a birth certificate or a social security number, /EIN. The Treasury Direct account must be funded by the owner through the payroll deductions and purchased directly from the owner's personal bank account to have any value. Okay, this is partial truth. Okay, this is not whole truth because they're telling you only part of the story, but we're not here to argue about that. Okay, please be advised that trying to defraud the government by claiming rights to bogus securities is a violation of federal law. Excuse me? Trying to defraud? How are you trying to defraud the government by claiming rights to bogus security? Just state for a fact that there are no funds associated with my account whatsoever, that the government is not holding my property in trust. Just tell me that we're not in a current economic emergency. It won't let me click on it, okay? Just that. That's all you got to do is tell me the government's not holding my property in trust. Because if they're not holding my property in trust, that means that it's violating its own act, the Act of March 9, 1933. Now, I'm not saying for you to say this to them. I'm saying this is the conversation I would have if we were having a conversation. All right? So, those of you who are trying to access the so-called TDA account, just remember and understand they changed the process. Just remember that just because the Treasury says something on its website, okay, remember, this is just, look, there is no revision date or nothing. This is just a web page. There is no authorization or anything. Hold on, let me see if I can show you what I mean. Go to the top of the website. Hold on. This is an official site of the United States government. You don't see that, do you? You don't see nothing about this being an official website of the United States government. Interesting. Now, watch this. We done already told y'all. Show you how they're not backing up what they're saying. But you guys, this is for your benefit. Okay? Many of you try to go into court and you try to write papers and you try to repeat what you hear me say. Ladies and gentlemen, when I write something, there is somebody that I'm trying to get in touch with and that person just emailed. Okay, yeah, I gotta talk to that person, but we're gonna go to the treasury.gov. I thought U.S. currency is legal tender for all debts, okay? Now, let's go to the treasury.gov, their resource center, okay? Because remember, I want you to pay attention. We just went to a treasury site, and what did that treasury site tell us? That treasury site tried to tell us what the truth was, but that treasury site did not say an official website of the United States government. Hold on. Gotta let y'all see it. But this is from Treasury Direct, but no official site of the United States government. Hold on. Look at the bottom. See, savings bonds have a date, but this particular article doesn't have a date. Wait. Hold on. This particular article has a date. It even has the Department of the Treasury seal at the bottom. Take a look. And it, oh, by the way, this one, even though there are some misnomers in here, it uses case law. Hold on. Let's show you the case law. See, there's your Legal Tender Act. The Gold Coinage Act should be in here as well. Okay. So it actually puts that in, gives you links. Let's go back here about these individuals talking about birth certificate.
Bogus signed drafts, bills of exchange.
Another Treasury letter, but where is the information on negotiable instruments? Why are they not giving you the definition for a negotiable instrument? Or why are they not talking about negotiable instruments? Okay, why are they not signing this? You just get links at the bottom. This is like one of those other sites that some other, let me get the word right, that some other internet blog or video use this to make fake claims about the United States birth certificate. Okay, if this website was really official and if the information in it was really stuff that they would be standing by, guess what? Then they would do this. It would be updated. Then they would author it by saying that. An official website of the United States government. But you don't see that happening in Treasury Direct as part of the United States Department of the Treasury. Now, hold on. Let's see if we can do that. Let's see. This is Mariah, and she's talking about visions, y'all. Okay, I typed in Treasury Direct, okay? And I typed in Treasury Direct on purpose because I want to go directly.
You want to go directly?
To the Treasury Direct.
You want to go directly to the Treasury Direct?
That's right.
But where's their website?
I don't know. So let's see. See, the Treasury Direct doesn't have their own separate site. So let's go here. Straight to the night. So alone. Suffered from alienation. Okay, this is Treasury Direct website, ladies and gentlemen. This is their website. Let's see. Look at that. Treasury Direct website doesn't have anything associating it with government. It's just a page. It's just a web page. Why is that? And I click on government, and it's the government section. Let's see if there's any authorization at the bottom. No copyright label. No nothing. Oh, no, we do get a last update in November 2016. So what's the difference between this junk and this junk? No, not that junk. Uh-oh, I closed it.
Oh my God, I closed it.
All right. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, there are people out there putting out videos saying that this is not legitimate, that's not legitimate, this is that. They say a lot, but they don't provide any proof. Okay? The idea is this is all about tendering payment. This is about no longer using so-called instruments called checks. This is about no longer using the routing numbers. The reason why we don't use routing numbers at the bottom of our instrument with their routing number symbol is because those symbols are copywritten. So we don't use copyright. But here's the thing, ladies and gentlemen. If they get to create laws, create situations, create circumstances, shouldn't you also have the same rights to do the exact same thing? Now, what do I mean? Well, they get to say, this is wrong, that's wrong, this is wrong, that's wrong, only when it applies to someone under their jurisdiction. Well, if you have the right to not consent, then you also have the right to start filing what's called administrative complaints. Everybody's been trying to handle things through the courts. But remember, the courts are administrative. So you need to start handling things administratively. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to continue. We got Dougie Fresh, and he's going to take us out of here because he's asking, what is your name? Dougie Fresh and the Get Fresh Crew. And he's singing a song called D-E-F, which is the acronym for death, but for also Doug E. Fresh, DEF number 3 on your telephone dial. Doug E. Fresh, have a good day, everyone.